good morning to you too. I didn't see you there.
Tarek?
What are you doing?
Is that you?
What? What are you talking about? I'm standing right here. You walked right by me.
I didn't recognize you in your thumble.
Oh, it's camo, so all the investors don't see me when we're bidding on houses.
I just really didn't recognize you.
Man, do you see how big this lot is?
No, I haven't seen anything yet.
The lot wraps all the way around. Hey, when did you get here, Jeff?
I've been standing here for a while, man.
You didn't see Tarek because he's camo.
Dude, where'd you go, bro? Where'd you go?
It's a two-bedroom, one-bathroom, almost 1,300-square-foot house, and the seller's asking $450.
Think.
It's really what we can get the house for. So the seller's asking $450. All right, but before I get to all my numbers, what do you think, Jeff?
So I think you're gonna come in 92. That'd be finishing the garage as is.
All right.
All right.
Let you know.
All right, let me know, you guys. See ya.
All right, Jeff, so what did you find out about doing an ADU here?
When I spoke with the city, they said they actually had permits on this thing, but he never got it finalized. So we've got to go reinstate the permits, get all the inspections signed off.
So what's your best guess on how long it's going to take to convert the garage into an ADU?
I'm going to guess 6 months to a year.
A year?
A year.
To get that thing approved, finished, signed off.
Let me think about this. 5 seconds. So here's why it's tough. We have this big, beautiful property, tiny little two-bedroom house. This property is screaming for more square footage.
Totally.
If the market goes down over the year, when we go to sell a year from now, we're gonna lose money.
Right, and this is a tricky year. I don't know what's gonna happen.
We've been going up so long. I mean, I don't see another couple years of this. So we can get in and out 2.5 to 3 months, or we can go for a big profit and spend a year here.
Paint samples. I was thinking this one for the body of the house.
So all the siding?
Yeah. And then for trim, we kind of like a charcoal or a white. And then we could do a pop of color for the front door. This is a little safer to do the white.
You know what? Let's go safer.
Okay. There's something else that I noticed. Huh. Do you see like all this like rubble right here? That I think is coming from the roof. The roof is made of rocks.
So we've had some rain and I didn't see any water damage in the house. So do you think we can pull off selling the house with that roof?
You wanna leave a roof from 1962 made of rubble? Why don't you ask Jeff what it's gonna cost? He's inside.
Jeffrey! Jeff!
Hello. What's up, dude?
I got a question for you.
Yep.
We have a rock roof. I mean, in your opinion, can we keep it? What's the condition?
Look, inside, you don't have any leaks right now. But you've got some problems on the outside. You can see across, we've got a lot of rot on the fascia. We've got rot in the tails. And it is an ugly roof. It's also an expensive roof.
How much?
I can't really hear you from here.
It would be $21,000.
Why would it be $21,000 for a roof, Jeff?
$21,000.
It's a tiny two-bedroom, one-bathroom house. Why?
Because this thing's a hot mop roof with rock right over it. People can't just go and scrape off all the shingles. So they got to get rid of all the rock first. And then underneath the rock, you have all the tar.
You want to spend $21,000 on a roof?
We're redoing the entire house. We can't leave that.
All right, fine, $21,000. Let's replace the roof.
All right, I'll go get the permits
pulled. Did you say yes? I can't hear you.
I said yes.
Yes.
I said yes. What's up, Tim?
That looks pretty.
How's it going?
You know what, I actually dig that tile. You know, I thought it was gonna be a little bit busy, but it's kind of not.
No, it looks gorgeous. And I think I saw the tub in here. Look, see, it's a big tub. It's pretty, right? I think with that tile flowing around it, it just adds like a nice little feature. It's good. The cabinets look good. I like the color.
The cabinets look good, but we got some bad news.
What?
Someone broke into the garage, stole all the tile.
All the backsplash?
All the backsplash.
That was $2,000 worth of tile.
Wasn't cheap.
Loved that backsplash. It went perfect with the cabinets and everything. And it was expensive, and I convinced you to use it because there wasn't that much backsplash.
Uh-huh. So now it's gone.
Now what?
I'm thinking white subway tile. It's in stock and it's cheap.
It's gonna look so plain. Let's first see if they have it in stock.
Hey, Tim.
What's up?
Do you know how long it'll take to get new tile?
Maybe 2 weeks.
Can we work on other things if we order that tile while we're waiting?
Yes, you can. We can work around it.
Okay, let's order it.
You do it? Okay, good.
Got this thing done pretty quick, huh?
Yeah, I think adding the fence was a nice touch.
How's that roof looking? That's the big question. I mean, it looks a lot better without all those rocks.
Definitely worth the money. It does have great curb appeal now. The paint colors look great. I love that we have some nice lawn out here.
Ooh, the door's cute. You know the best part about this house?
What?
We got it done super fast.
Yes.
Welcome home. First impression, super nice.
So light and bright. Love that fireplace.
Was it worth it?
Oh my gosh, yes.
It does look good.
It looks really nice. You have a nice family room, cute dining area, and then the kitchen.
I mean, before, you gotta remember, the kitchen ended up right here.
My favorite part of the entire home, the backsplash. I know it got stolen.
Hey, you like it the first time we bought it or the second time?
I like it both times. The cabinet color, I think it would've looked kind of washed out if we would've done all white.
And laundry room's cute.
Let's check out the bathroom.
Great bathroom, look at the size of this thing.
Definitely added everything that a buyer would want. A huge tub, gorgeous tile, a large shower, double sinks.
I like how we carry the tile around the bathtub too.
Me too.
Bedroom number one. Oh, it's cute how they staged it for two kids. All right, does this feel like a primary? Kinda.
Well, it works. It is under 1,300 square feet, so I don't think any buyers are gonna expect a huge bedroom. The backyard.
Now this was a behemoth to tackle. Look at that, we leveled out the backyard. We got rid of that weird step up. We got a beautiful garage, brand new driveway. And then moving the fence, it made it so much better.
It did. It's a perfect blank slate. And you can tell they can easily do an addition. This is gonna be what sells the home.
It would have been nice to do an ADU.
Right, but we got it done quick. 3 months?
3 months.
It looks great. So, what are we gonna list it for?
Ooh.
So, what are the numbers?
We paid $425,000 for the house, spent $135,000 on the remodel. We're gonna have $30,000 in closing costs, selling costs. So our break-even's gonna be $590,000.
Okay.
The only problem we're facing is we have no two-bedroom comps. All the comparable properties are three-bedroom, two-bathroom, and they're selling high sevens to low eights, but they're not fixed up like our house.
And what do you wanna list for?
I think we can go $799,900.
$799,900, the same price as a three-bedroom, $799,900.
Yeah, you can get an older three-bedroom or a brand new two-bedroom. Here's the thing, we have a break-even of $590,000. If we sell this thing anywhere near $800,000, the entire thing was worth it.
It was a very smart move, getting in and out quickly.
And the market is still hot.
Well, $799,900.
$799,900.
Worth a shot.
Don't forget the nine, $799,900.
$799,900.
All right.
Deciding not to do an ADU is tough, but trusting our gut and flipping the house quickly was the right call. After a week on the market and two offers, we're in escrow at $850,000. If this deal closes, we stand to make a profit of $260,000. Time to find another house to flip.